knowledgeable about football who suggested that Prismal should go to centre-half forward is absolutely correct.
And the other big thing here, Kev, North Ballarat haven't played it.
Haven't got a spare. Lucy,
so it's game on here.
Yep.
One-on-ones all across the ground. We're just about to get underway in the second half. It's Western Region by 1 point, 7.8.50 to 7.7.49. The ball tossed up in the middle. Murray Boyd got the tap down, double-fisted it forward. In there was Daniel Tung for Ballarat, but it's going to come the way of Western Region. Hand pass out wide. Matt Ryan got a hand pass over the top. Sablich got a kick to left half forward. Diving in there for Ballarat, though. Trying to receive a hand pass. Running past was Reece Miles. Couldn't get his hands on it, but Ballarat, quick kick out of the pack towards centre wing. Flying across good the punch, front of the pack punch. And did well, front and centre. Now the kick inside the 50. Oh, it fell in the lap, though, of Ryan Hobbs, just floating back. And did a bit of a somersault as he came down, but he hung on to it.
Good spoil by Harley Weston across half back then, set that up.
Kicks one out towards our position, just hanging back. Derek McAuliffe couldn't get the hands on the footy. Now Western Region through a string of hand passes and out the back.
Good vision.
Brian Graham needs to kick it, though. He wobbled one towards full forward. Diving under there was Paul O'Shea. Couldn't quite bring down the mark. But on the left boot was Panayi. He kicks to an open goal square. Is it going to go through it?
Oh, it hit the woodwork.
I think it nicked the goalpost on the way through. It looked the goods from up here, but it's just a minor score. 7-9-51 to 7-7-49, and we've returned just as we left off. High intensity stuff in the early going of the third, just a minute and a half in. It's a spearing ball that's turned over, though. Oh, not umpire called play on.
Really?
Almost a mark. Sablich was the man who tried to hang on to it. Now Graham, now they've paid a free kick. It's going to go
Ballarat's
way.
Second throw of the
day. Davey's got to hold his feet there, Kev. Sablich, yeah. He just goes to ground too often.
Bucknell goes backwards now. Deep in defence. Oh, got him. He's left it behind as Hind, and as surely this could be a score. Socket off the ground. Is it going to make it through, Hort, the last minute? Hort had the makings of a ripper. But it was just a score to the
Jace
line.
Perkins.
That's better. Locking it in the pressure now, Kev. We didn't have that in the first quarter.
Yep.
So the pressure mounts on Ballarat. Gary Turner on 88.9 Win FM offering us his expert comments.
Pearls of wisdom.
And now Ballarat can work it out their right half-back flank.
Stephen Tom who?
The ball is smothered there. It's Miles, he handballs inside 50 to Jenkins now. Jenkins kicks to... and he's hooked it. One behind, so it's three straight behinds. The Western Region start this third quarter. The score's now 7-11-53 to 7-7-49 as we have gone 3 minutes, third quarter. Kick in from Hind. It's a long one. Goes to McAuliffe. He's outnumbered here.
Numbers
work for the Western Region football. Armstrong Weston handballs inside 50 to Brian Graham. He chips it. Misses. Jenkins, too tall for him. Now the ball's going to be cleared here by Ballarat. Sablich is under it. Fisted to the front. Matty Dean now in space. Chipping ball inside 50 to a 2-on-1. The ball is punched out of bounds. We have a throw in about 45 metres out from the Western Region football goal on the grandstand side here at Witten Oval.
Just one thing that sticks out, boys, already is our pressure and locking it in and numbers around the ball at the moment. We've just got to capitalise and get a score on the board out.
Hung on to was Hind, but he dropped it. Now it's got underway of Kennedy.
So
he's brought down.
It's got to be holding the ball.
Umpire lets play on. Comes out the back. Quick hands, and now Ballarat can get going. Notman running through defensive 50. Kicks in the side, the middle of the ground. Cupido nudged out of the contest. Well by Ferrari, I believe it might have been, or Quick. And now Western Region can clear it out. Or Graham, at the last minute, decided not to go for the mark. Sablich did so instead, gave the hand pass off inside 50. O'Shea went for the footy.
Caught behind.
Well Finish done there. And the Prismal. Hand pass over the top. And Prismal curls one through on the left. And the perfect start. They missed a couple to start the quarter, but now one goes through. And it's a 10-point lead to the home side. 8-11-59 to 7-7-49.
A good thing here, Kev Abbott and Costello. He's starting to get his hands on the ball in the... Castellani here. Yep. A couple of second and third efforts, and that one there, he just fed out the left handball to Prismal, and he went bang.
Been terrific for Sunshine from all reports during the year. We'll get to see him in a couple of weeks' time, but yeah, he's fitted into the Sunshine Footy Club very, very nicely under Brendan and the boys over there. Kinder Smith Reserve.
It's ball back in the middle, 10-point lead to the Western Region Football League. Umpire throws it up. Boyd wins the hit out to Miles, but he's tackled quickly. Ball's in dispute, hacked out of there by Jared Graham for Ballarat. Kicks it to half forward. Savlich does well, good use of the body, forced the ball to ground. That goes out wide to Panay. His handball is smothered. Goes to Hind. Now, the ball
oh,
is...
Oh, that's ball.
The you're right, Smackers. Yeah, he's holding the ball against Kennedy. Free kick to Panay. And now, oh, shocking kick by Panay. Luckily, it bounced back for him. There's a worse handball now. Kennedy's got it for Ballarat. He's tackled now. But he's able to get his hands free. He goes to Sortino. Now he handballs to Del Papa. Now the kick comes inside 50. And standing under it is
Finko.
Finko, well spoilt there. Dean gets it to Magna Bosco. Now to Graham. He stubbed his toe as he kicked it. And the ball comes out wide to Prismal. Tried to keep it in, but it's just walked over the line. With absolutely no pressure. And that was Buckwell who saw Raven Lever a throw in about 60 metres out for the Western Region goal.
He had all the time in the world then, Graham, and it... I don't know if he stubbed his toe or... Geez, it was a terrible kick going forward.
McAuliffe in a bit of trouble here on the boundary line, going down in the rooms for Ballarat.
10 points the lead from the throw-in. Western Region trying to just will it forward. They've got it inside 50. Right, a pack forms and the umpire will ball it up. About 49 metres out, right half forward flank. Again, no space in there. The umpire will have to do it again. So 8-11, plays 7-7 after nearly 7 minutes of the third. Ballarat without a score in the early stages. Tapped into a bit of space, trying to just barge his way through as Finko. He couldn't. He was brought down in a tackle. Now Horbury for Ballarat. A little bit of space. Hobbs in there, trying to just track it to the boundary. Kennedy did well. Waited just... momentarily, and now does they just work it via handballs through the 50. Oh, that was not the best kick there from Hind. It was chopped off. Hand pass out the back. Graham's running past. Numbers. If he can receive the hand pass, he does now. From 45 on the run, he squares it up underneath it, trying to take the mark. Front position was Perkins, and he drags down his Ballarat opponent. And in the goal square, we've got a loose footy. Perkins just grabs it out there again, and they scramble for it at the top of the goal square. At the last line of defence, though, it is rushed over. And Ballarat breathe a sigh of relief. Just a minor score for Western Region. 8-12-60, 7-7-49. It was frantic stuff on the last line of defence. And now they can clear it through Hind, who does the kicking in. It was a dangerous kick, and it is fisted out of bounds.
That was a better kick going forward by Graham. Then he sees the kick to the top of the square, give Perkins a chance to jump at it, and then we got the numbers at the ground. We should have been rewarded with a hole in the ball there.
Yeah, absolutely.
So the throw in now. Boyd wins the hit out, gets it to Jenkins. Handball's back to Miles. And it's just outside 50 now. Centering ball to the top of the square, looking for Perkins, but he can't work in front. Now it's picked up by Pring there for Ballarat. Now they clear. Long ball down the middle. Look, it's a Ferrari with the spoil. Almost a clever tap there by Cooper.
That's a throw.
It's picked up by Dean. And now the kick comes out wide to Savlich. Wheels back onto his left foot, goes inboard. Shocking kick to turn over here for the Western Region Football League. But a good defensive tackle. Holding the man has been paid. Free kick going Ballarat's way.
It's gone up a notch again.
I think that's going to Dalahy.
The defence has, hasn't it? Certainly lifted from both sides.
That's Bolton with the free kick. Goes out wide. Finds Horbury. Now goes over the top. Finds Pring. It's about 70 from goal. Now kicks to the hot spot. Looking for a marking target. There's none there. Ball spills to the front of the pack. Langlands clears for the Western Region Football. Handball's back to Ferrari. Now his long ball out towards the Dougie Hawkins wing.
He's going to mark this.
A 2-on-1. Castellano did all right, but there's too many numbers there. Graham picks up. Well, Ballarat now to kick inside 50. He's an absolute bullet, and he's found Mitch Banner, and he'll kick for about 45 out on a slight angle.
It's a bad option coming out of the back line there by Ferrari there. He kicked it to the smallest bloke on the ground, Abbott Costello, and he had four blokes on his feet there. So
Banner, former Port Adelaide listed player, kicks now. And he's pushed it to the right for one behind. He's got one goal two this afternoon, Mitch Banner. And the lead is back to 10 points, 8-12-60, 7-8-50, Ballarat.
It's all just going to come down to making the right decisions at the right time here under pressure, and this is what it's all about, interleague football.
There's a lot of cool heads out there. I mentioned then that kick out from defence was by one of the younger players in the Western Region lineup. We just need the cool heads to prevail here.
The long kick out spilled over the back. Graham got the hand pass over to Bolton, who kicked it back inside 50. Banner was there again. Couldn't quite hang on to the mark. Western Region get the clearing hand pass, but it's going to be Bolton again. He got the hand pass back over. This time Notman sends one high up and under the top of the goal square there, about 15 out, but floating back. Boyd, it was no mark paid. And now under immense pressure, the clearing hand pass was good.
Good.
And it found Mills. And now he gave it off to Bench, who received the Shepherd and now backed himself well. Took the hit as he kicked it to centre-half forward, floating in from the side. Well done now by Jenkins. He kicks towards full forward. Underneath it, he used his body beautifully, did Castellano, and he can just run in and kick a much-needed goal.
That was better play. Coming out of the back line, the run and carry with Bench, a good Shepherd by Mills, his teammate from Albion, and then the long kick direct. Timmy Jenkins front and centre, just smart on the boot on his left side. He put it out in front of Abbott Costello there. He just let his opponent under the ball, and then he dribbled through. That's better going forward. That's what we need.
Well, the use of the body was perfect, and then he just ran into an open goal. 9-12-66 now to 7-8-50. It's out to a 16-point lead. Almost 12 gone of the third.
There's his first rest there, Kev, the big fella. He's rucked tirelessly all day. We should take advantage now while he's off.
Knackered.
String of handballs from Langlands ends up kicking short. Now goes to Boyd. He's in space. Handballs over the Bench. Now on his left boot goes long, looking to get the ball inside 50. Prismal's there, but the ball beats him and his opponent out of bounds. They're throwing about 60 metres around from the Western Region goal. 12 minutes gone, third quarter, 16 points the lead. Ball's tossed back in.
Just get that feeling, a couple of goals here from the Western Region
could break
Ballarat.
Free kick's being picked out of the ruck, and it's going to Carey for Ballarat. He's at right half back. He's looking for options. Goes short. The ball was almost chopped off there by Miles, and the ball now spills out of bounds. They gained about 20 metres there at Ballarat, and we'll have another throw in. The margin still 16 points.
That's better pressure out of the back line. That was too easy in the first half, so there's one area we've really picked up on and closed their space down.
So Armstrong, Weston and Carey go in the ruck. Carey gets the tap out. Pring gets it, now gives it to Hine. Clearance here for Ballarat as Pring kicks the ball straight down the middle of Witten Oval. Mark almost taken by Ferrari, but now Ballarat's away. It's going through Bucknell. Now the ball's inside 50 with Bolton. Bolton has a shot on goal, and he has put it through. Good play there from the back line by Ballarat as they kick their eighth of the afternoon as they trail by 10 points. 9-12-66, the Western Region Football League to Ballarat, 8-8-56, 10 points. Lead 13 and a half minutes gone third quarter.
We just spoke about the pressure off our half forward line there, but that ball just come out too easy, and they went through the corridor. Just a spilt chest mark there. They had numbers running through, and a good finish into the breeze there. We just needed that. We just can't get the next goal, can we, to get 24 points in front out?
10 points the difference now from the restart. It goes Western Region's way. A couple of quick hand passes. Finko tries to get his hands on the foot. He was tackled by three players. Now he lost it. Almost played holding the ball, but not quite. Now out the back, Dean. That was a scrubby kick, and you can imagine that was the bounce that it was going to get. And now the kick inside 50. One out in there for Ballarat. Trying to, they both go to ground, though. Running over the back. Well done by Sablich. He did well. Now he was dragged down. And Ballarat was holding the footy. Advantage paid. And running into an open goal is Notman. And they get two in the space of about 35 seconds. And it's a back to a four-point margin.
We speak about it again. Just under pressure, the disposal. Bad kick by Matty Dean on his non-preferred, but you've still got to hit that target, Kev, because if we had to hit that target, we're around the bound.
Gone, yeah. Off.
9-12 to 9 goals 8.
And you mentioned it again, Davey Savage's just got to hold his feet.
He goes to ground too often. Maybe his nickname's Autumn Leaves.
Yeah, it might be. Well, he went to ground up here in the on the Geelong Road end earlier that cost a goal as well, so he just has to hold his feet.
All right. 4 points the margin. Ball's back in the middle. Tossed up. Boyd with the hit out decisively. Hits it to Horbrand. He's wrapped up by Jenkins, and we'll have a second ball up.
Just seven-man forward line kept, so there's a change now with Eames. He's going to match him up. So that's one thing they've learnt from the first quarter here.
From the toss-up, ends up throw.
Oh, 50.
No, can't be 50.
It is. No, it's not.
Where the ball's ended up now, we should be able to get numbers back and man up here.
So free
kick. No, he's playing the 50.
Oh, yeah. He has.
Okay. So 50.
Oh, we need to get numbers Finco. Back in there enough.
So the 50 was against Finco. Free kick's going to Horbury, and the man on the mark is just inside the 50. So won't be able to get. Wouldn't think he'd be able to get the distance from there. He's lining up like he's going to. Now the pass is on. He's got a man in space. Good spoil over the pack by Quick. The ball fell to Giampaolo. He had a snap around the body and put it out on the full. Oh, was it touched? That's touched. We'll get a throw in. We've got a left forward pocket for Ballarat.
Final score, Parkside 13-15-93. Defeated Sanctuary Lakes 5-5-35.
Just toss back in now. Boyd again wins the hit out.
Can't afford to concede a goal here.
We're going to have to run it out. Forms,
I think he's holding the ball, and it is. I think it's going to get Horbury for dragging it back in. Free kick going to Jenkins.
We're going to have to go sideways here.
Now the kick comes out of defence, looking for Langlands. Takes the mark on the defensive 50.
It goes down the line. Ballarat's got all the numbers.
Yeah, because we push the numbers back. And that's where the stoppage.
And that's where the kick goes. O'Shea flies. Well done. Oh, almost that's took the mark. Good second effort. Feeds the handball out to Jenkins. Good take the mark. But it's Hind who gets it. Then gets it to Daniel Kennedy, who kicks forward. Mark taken there by Notman. Now goes over the top to Pring, who plays on. Handball's back to Notman. He's outside 50 now. Kick goes back inboard.
Good pressure, Matty Dean.
Oh, free kick.
Spoil there by Banner. Free kick wasn't paid. If Boyd tries to take a couple on it, he's wrapped up in a
strong
tackle.
That'll be a free kick.
And it is.
Yep, told you.
Right. Free kick against Magna Bosco. He's going to go to Pring. He's going to kick in the left forward pocket. Tight angle as he kicks from almost on the boundary line here at Witten Oval. Centres it though, Pring. Oh, no. He's got a man on. Good
That's
play.
Slack.
And quickly, mark is paid. And quick kick is hooked to the left and it's missed. So the margin is now 3 points. Western Region Football League 9-12-66. To the Ballarat Football League 9-9-63. 18 minutes gone, third quarter.
And this is one area where we've really fell down out, is getting this kick out right, Kev. We just seem to turn it over here. Oh, look at that.
Short pass, looking for Bench. Wasn't great, fell short of him, but he got the hand pass to Spiteri, and now he's going to get it back. Darts around McAuliffe, and now gets a kick out towards the wing, right in front of our commentary position. Good spoil from the defending Ballarat player there in... It was Valet. He did well to force the halved contest. We'll have a ball up.
A few tight boys here, Kev.
Yeah,
just struggling to get to this ball up, aren't they?
Up they go again. It was well done there by O'Shea. Got the tap forward now. Graham just hacks it onto his boot. Underneath it, front position. Couldn't quite take the mark. Tracking it towards the boundary line. Oh, that was scooted over. Too tough to call, but it'll be thrown in. About 60 around from Western Region's goal.
We need a goal there, boys.
Yeah, certainly do.
They led by as much as 16 points early in the quarter. They kicked the first couple of the term, had all the play, but Ballarat have come storming back. And there is not a whole lot of that
didn't
breeze
know, didn't
out
have
there.
It. That was a fair free kick, that one.
not sure the breeze is as much of a factor as it was earlier in the match.
Now, if you look at the flags at the back there over on the Geelong Road end, yeah, it's still pretty blistery. Blistery.
Ballarat just switch it across now. Daniel Kennedy with the ball in hand. Goes across, unable to find the target. This might be a chance for Western Region. Underneath it there was Prismal laying a tackle. But Ballarat still able to find their way out. Short pass, the ruckman floating back. Back on the ground, Ben Sortino, he takes the mark. Gives the hand pass across the ground. It was Kennedy again. Got the kick towards four to the wing. Running onto it there was Notman. Sees it over the boundary line for Ballarat. So we're just four to the wing on the Doug Hawkins side of the ground. 3 points Western Region's lead. We've just ticked into time on. We spoke about it at the start of this term. You'd think they would need at least a four goal lead to feel at least somewhat comfortable they could hang on. So 3 points might not get it done. The kick forward.
Couldn't play that deliberate.
Out of the pack. Gains about 40, 50 metres.
Steve Kennedy wanted it.
Yep.
He was appealing for it.
So it's out of play. Four to the wing on Western Region's attacking side. Toss back into play. Sortino, front of the pack, got the tap down. Further way of Hind. Now out wide, the high kick up and under. We're on true centre wing now. Players battle for it. One of them was Del Papa. Now Graham throws it onto the boot. Finko was underneath it, but Ballarat had the numbers. Taking a bounce across centre half back. A little grubbering kick was well worked. Now Kennedy. They find a bit of space on the broadcast side. That was a kick out to the advantage of Bucknell. He danced around his teammate and then let himself down with his disposal. Could have spotted up a player.
He could have nearly ran and carried again and taken the bounce because he had Mills burnt.
Yeah, he did. Mills was gone.
Yep.
Good effort from Mills, but he was shot.
Out of bounds on the full, and Western Region will take it from their right back pocket.
So Dean is going to take the kick.
There's just no run from behind here, Kev, or no switch or anything now.
He's forced to go long down the line looking for Armstrong. Western put his hands to it, unable to take the mark. Rove there by Bench. Gets the handball back to Brian Graham. He's wrapped up in a tackle right in front of the Western Region interchange bench. He'll have a ball up. 22 minutes gone, third quarter. Armstrong Western taps it over the back, gives it to his opponent. Brian Graham's in there, trying to dig it out, and we'll get another ball up.
Just need someone to take this game by the scruff of the neck for the Western Region at the minute.
They need a highlight, don't
they? Yeah, they do.
Sortino on someone's head or something.
Got the hit out, clearance there by Tung. Bangs it inside 50. Paul spills to Cupido. Gets a beautiful handball to Pring, who bends it around the corner, but he's missed. Puts it through for one behind. And the margin now 2 points. 9-12-66 to 9-10-64.
Unkind bounce.
Yeah, that was a beautiful bit of handiwork there from Cupido.
Yeah, you can tell that those players play AFL, their hands.
How quick was his hands? Yeah.
Play on from the kick in.
Be a dealer at
the
Crown Casino.
As they can. McDonald was underneath. It couldn't take the mark. Just a little bit scrappy with their skills. It comes out to Finko. Now Graham. Hand pass over the top. Went for his brother in Chris over there, but it had too much on it. Now Graham, that's Jared for Ballarat, gets it. Now it comes out wide to Notman. And he goes over the top to Banner. Takes a bounce. Kicks inside 50. Top dangerous spot. It was the hot spot underneath there. Bench. Tracked it and then got it. Got the hand pass away. Now he's going to get it back at left half back. But they just scrap around with it through the middle. Bench still going hard at it with ball in hand. Gets it back to Chris Graham. Pumps one long to centre half forward with the flight. Unable to take the mark though for Ballarat. And they still might work it out though.
Well done, Prismal.
Tapped forward. This might work out all right for them. The hand pass comes back, Finko in a bit of space, little toe poke under the pack, might work out all right. Perkins, though, with three a beat, he might do well to force a stoppage here, and he does. He sees it over the boundary line, and that could have been just as easily worked out by the Ballarat defence. So we'll have a throw in 25 metres around from their goal in the right forward pocket.
We need something special here from the little blokes here, Joshie McDonald or Todd Finko.
That's going to be
a free kick.
Jeremy Mills. Just a little bit aggressive with the hit out. So Ballarat take it. Horbury went across the face of goal, found Anderson, drew the man, and then gave a hand pass over the top. Just going for a little stroll, not really breaking out of second gear over there. His Grant Valet. But then he kind of worked himself into trouble. It was well done by Western Region, and they might go forward again. Gee, that was a good hand pick up by Dean. Got the hand pass over the top. Graham's there, was tripped over. Dives on the footy, gets the hand pass away. At the back now. Working his way through. Spiteri did well. Kicked inside the 50. Climbing up over the pack. He had to sit, was O'Shea. But Ballarat again through Hind, who's had it probably 40 times today already. A kick out wide to centre wing. They all climb in. Umpires picked out a free kick, I reckon. Or it was a mark. One or the other. And Ballarat can go forward. Kennedy receives the hand pass. Was looking for Jared Graham. He never got it. Maybe his teammate had, opponent had him, and the umpires picked out a free kick.
Free kick.
Jesus. Holding the man.
Both sides don't want to win this game. The turnovers now with the pressure. It's we need steady heads here.
The free kick's been paid to Giampaolo.
Did anyone see Murray Boyd go off the ground? No, he's obviously not on the ground, but he's been off the ground for a fair while.
Giampaolo finds Horbury with a chipping kick. That's going back to Giampaolo. He's out right, half back. They had another one. They're swapped, just waxing it here. Goes back to Horbury. And he goes back to Giampaolo.
Well, one point of difference. Why wouldn't they be doing this?
Yeah, that's right.
26 minutes gone. Third quarter. Now they're forced to go down the line. The ball's chopped off there. Good mark by Spiteri.
We'll try and get him through the corridor out.
Hurt himself, though, in the marking contest. Slow to get up.
Just no movement forward of the ball here. No leading up.
Spiteri.
It would just be bombed.
Handball's back. Now it ends up with Brian Graham.
Run it in,
finds it to his brother Chris. He kicks inside 50, looking for Perkins. Can't take the marks. Ball spills to the pack. That's all Ballarat here.
Good tackle
there. Now the ball spills out to Vales. Gets the clearing kick and a mark taken there by the Ballarat League. Ball goes back inside to Horbury. He's held up.
They are out if they want it.
Handballs to Giampaolo. Now the handball again, looking for Dalahee, unable to get it, but he recovers. Gives it back to Giampaolo. Now the kick inside 50. He's got too much on it. And the clip mark taken by Ferrari. He now clears the defensive 50. Finds Panea out on centre wing, right in front of the broadcast booth here. Goes long down the line. Prismal.
Well done, Prismal.
Right on Prismal. Needs to move it quickly.
Yeah, we've got one on once.
Swings onto his left boot. He's got Perkins in space on the lead. Unable to take the mark. Ball goes to the back. O'Shea handball, misses the target. Horbury gets it, gives it to Dalahay. He's tackled. Panay intercepts the mark.
O'Shea.
50. Panay bombs it long and it just fades at the last moment, just through for one behind. 27 and a half minutes gone, third quarter, lead back out to 3 points. Western Region 9-13-67 to Ballarat 9-10-64.
Jeez, I thought Josh Perkins was stiff not to get a free kick there. Kev, the bloke took his eye off the ball and pushed him straight in the middle of the back.
Yeah, I thought so too, but...
Well, that could have been the moment from Panay. It had the makings of something great. It would have given them a spark. But as it stands, the margin is 3 points. And again, we wouldn't be far away from three-quarter time. 28 gone in the third.
I think it's Murray Boyd back on the ground.
Now the kick comes out wide. Armstrong Weston did well. Got his hands on the footy. And now the kick comes back inside 50. Perkins flew at the footy, then gathered his own crumb. But he's given away a free kick. And Ballarat earn a reprieve at fullback.
He got the Ballarat jumper on under his shirt.
Now, smackers, I wasn't going to say that, but geez, I was thinking it.
Kev, that was good hard, tough lead, wasn't it?
Graham now back inside 50. That's a poor kick. And another poorly executed kick from one of the great Western Region players.
It's going to hold him up.
Vales has it.
Just got to get their composure back, the boys. They've lost it a bit.
Poked one over the top. Horbury had it, then he gave it over the top, looking for Pitson. String of hand passes through the back half. Well done. Anderson was patient. Kicked a high up and under. Well done. Underneath it was Matt Dean for Western Region, but it was punched over the boundary line by Matthew Notman.
Just a bit of running around like chooks with heads cut off.
Yeah, we've just lost our structure.
Yeah, we have.
Forward, haven't we?
What's Timmy Quick doing up here?
Yeah, There's what have they got? Three. They've got eight in their back in our forward line now. Fumble.
Armstrong Weston reached over the top and ended up with Castellano. He just fumbled at the crucial moment. It was all it took for him to be wrapped up in a heavy tackle.
That's the story at the moment. They are fumbling a bit and just not taking their marks and just not sticking their tackles.
Both sides a little bit.
Aubrey,
there's plenty
the
of pressure
the
out there. Out. Graham at the foot of the pack got it and saw it off to Langlands, who just escorted it over the boundary line. So we're nearly 30 minutes gone in this third quarter. Only two goals each. Graham tries to barge his way through. May have been caught high. Umpire called play on. And now they all jump in there. Giampaolo's in there. So is Kennedy. Miles. And at the bottom of the pack was Tim Jenkins. Go up at it. Over the back again. Armstrong Weston strong at the tap. Graham beset upon. Couldn't quite get his hand out. He was caught high. This time the free kick's been picked out. It was Graham who caught him high. Just backwards of the wing here on the broadcast side. That's a better kick.
Yeah.
Well done. Spotted Miles, who just floated back. Found a bit of space there. He goes short. Pops one over the top. Good kick. Finko wheels onto his left boot. Goes long, sets one, sets sail from about 60. Has it got the legs? It's not quite. It's going to be touched on the line. Gee, it was a good looking kick off the boot.
That's a better build up.
Yep.
Just made the right decisions going forward, then held the ball up, waited for the right option.
9-14, 68 to 9-10, 64. We have set ourselves up for a thrilling finale here at Witten Oval this afternoon. That's a beautiful kick out from Ballarat.
Gee, their kick outs have been much better, haven't they?
They've been quick to get it out of there. Osgren, that's been the difference, really. Gee, Vales could have been off there if there wasn't Armstrong Weston wasn't in the way. He takes the mark on centre wing. Now goes long towards left half forward. Cupido one out. Front position just hung up in the wing in the end. And now Pring gets a little kick towards full forward. The bounce didn't favour the Western Region side. It almost favoured Jared Graham. But now it comes the way of Pitson, who popped one over the top. And now it comes to Lucas Anderson, who pops one over the top. And Pring just waltzes in and kicks his second goal of the day. And for the first time this afternoon, I believe, Ballarat have hit the front. 10-10-70 to 9-14-68. It's a two-point ball game.
It's just his work rate, Pring. He was the one that kicked the ball into the corridor. And then he just, no one just... went unchecked and followed the ball up and got the easy goal out. It's just coming back to work right now.
Yeah, absolutely. Final score from Newport. They have kept their unbeaten record at home intact. Only just 14-11-95. Sunshine Heights 14-7-91. So 4-point victory there for Newport Power.
Ball's back in the middle. Spills out wide. Langlands gets the clearance. Bombs it inside 50. Boyd's the target. Can't take the mark, but a good effort. Gets the handball out to Finko. Can he get on his left foot? No, he doesn't. Goes back to Magna Bosco. The right point post halfway up. 32 minutes, 45 seconds gone third quarter. 1 point in the margin. Western Region Footy League 9-15-69.
Dangerous kick in for Ballarat, but it just comes off. Anderson took the mark and fell over. What happens if there's a draw, gents? Do we have extra time in Interleague, or is it a draw?
That's a terrific question.
I have no idea. Because
one that I don't have an answer for. I'll tell you what happens if it's drawn at the end. I ring David Newton and ask him what happens.
Good idea.
Got no idea, to be honest.
Oh, there and there's the siren for three-quarter time, and, well, we probably could not have asked for a more intense third quarter. And kicking into the breeze, Ballarat have got the better of Western Region. They lead by a point at the final change. They kick 3-2 in that quarter. And they lead 10-10-70 to 9-15-69. So Western Region been wasteful at times in front of goal.
Really, isn't it?
They only got 5 down there in North Ballarat. No, 1, 2, 3, 4. No, they got 6.
They got 6.
Yeah, so, it's there to be won.
There's a bit of spying going on.
Cromay's doing a bit of radio espionage here, taking photos of the boys from the community station in Meltonham, their lineup, because Cromay doesn't like these cables. He wants this wireless free stuff. Get rid of these cables, Peter White. All right, we're ready to go for the last quarter. 1 point lead to Ballarat. Pepe.
You're on 88.9 Win FM. It's a 1 point lead to Ballarat as we get underway. The tap favoured Western Region, but Spud Graham was onto it straight away. And he got a kick forward inside the 50 for Ballarat. Unkind bounce for the forwards, though. And it, like a bit of a lucky little toe poke, came the way, though, of Sablich. Still scrambling for it in there. Langlands was onto it. They're diving in on there. Banner for Ballarat there, too.
She's going to have to turn the lights on her, boys, aren't they?
It's getting very dark out there.
Well, it's nearly 5 o'clock.
Well, they did start about half an hour late, didn't they, Kev?
Yeah, well, 2.30, 2.40 start, I think, by the time we
Banner
got down.
Banner sharked it from the ruck work. Got his kick smothered, though. And now, with a few players riding shotgun, Western Region can clear it out of defence. But again, just the kick favoured Miles. He jumped at it, knocked it to his advantage, and then tracked to the boundary line. Heard the voice. Now kicked towards half forward. No good, though. And now it's going to come back underneath it. Graham with courage. Well done. Did well, and now received the hand pass and pokes one short. That had too much on it. But luckily just bounces inside. Right in front of the Ballarat interchange bench. Right in front of us as well. So no score after just under a minute of the final term.
Murray Boyd's playing that loose man down back there, Kev.
Yeah, probably not a bad move.
Yep.
Sortino had front position, but it came the way of Dean for the Western Region. The umpire is going to come in and sort that out because ball was just locked in there.
Well, let's be honest, we need Tommy Langlands, we need Matty Dean, and we need Panay and them to get plenty of the ball if they're going to be on the nut in this last quarter.
Yep. Sortino got it, then it came the way of Armstrong Weston again. Dean couldn't keep it in. So another boundary throw in. Cramped on this grandstand side of the ground. It actually is a grandstand this time. Not used to that. But it's good.
Easily pleased.
Thrown back into play.
That bad a grinst.
Little toe poke from Jared Graham from Ballarat. Finds the boundary line.
So 2 minutes gone. No score in this final quarter. Umpire about to toss it back in. Right at the Ballarat interchange gate. Tossed in now. Sortino wins the hit out. It's a good handball there by Pitson. Tried to get it.
How did he get rid of that umpire?
Well, he got rid of it legally, apparently, so he ends up with
good
Kennedy.
Good pressure.
And then a handball by Giampala, and we'll have another throw in basically exactly the same spot with the Ballarat interchange bench. 2.5 minutes gone, first quarter.
Don't need Ballarat to get the first goal, Smackers.
No, exactly right, Kevin. The boys are hanging tough in here at the moment, the stoppages.
Kennedy.
The outside
run again. Hyde, and he's away. He's been fantastic today, Hyde, for Ballarat. Drives it long, inside 50, but there's no one home for Ballarat. And Murray Boyd, as Smacker said, that loose man in defence takes an easy mark. Oh. Now drives it straight down the middle. Dangerous kick, looking for Prismal. At his feet is just all Ballarat players. Handball inside 50 now, looking for Hyde. Picks it up. He tries to straighten up, but he's tackled as he handles.
Oh, you kidding.
Turn it up.
He paid the free kick for Hyde. It was a late call.
We're not biased, you know, but that wasn't a free kick. He tried to beat one too many.
Yep.
That's it. I picked it early, Kev. That bloke has got a Ballarat jumper under his green top.
Yeah, no, that was an ordinary decision. He'll look back at that one with his umpire's advisor and go, oh, yeah, you get that one wrong.
So Hyde's got the free kick. He's going to kick from 40 metres out directly in front. He's had a good afternoon, but yet to hit the scoreboard. Comes in now, Hyde. Kicks on its way. Umpire does not move. It is straight through the middle. Massive goal there for the Ballarat football there. They get the opening goal of the final quarter. Extend their lead to 7 points. Ballarat 10-11, 10-76 to Western Region 9-15-69.
Jeez, he's been good with his outside run all day. He's calmed us up.
Oh, yeah.
The difference here is the work rate. You know, from the 15-minute mark of that third quarter when we were 14 points in front, their work rate around the stoppages and their outside run has really carved us up here.
Yep. He's been terrific, Hyde. He's clearly their best player, along with the big bloke in the middle who's worked tirelessly all day too, Sortino. Yeah.
Off the half-back flank too, so he's caught the half-forward napping.
Up they go. Was Boyd in the ruck. Got it off, and now it comes the way of Finko. Kicks inside 50. It was a quick break out of the middle of the ground. Trying very quickly and slipping over. Jenkins trying to dart his way through. Timmy. He does, takes a bounce, hand pass the over himself. The top, Castellano. And the goal for Daniel Castellano.
Wowee.
There was a dance session in the left forward pocket.
That was unbelievable.
And it ends in a goal for the Western Region Footy League. They breathe life again. It's back to a 1-point lead to Ballarat, 10-15-75 to 11-10-76.
Yeah, we're busting those moves on the dance floor tonight,
it was
too.
Like the underground days, wasn't it, Kev? There's been a shuffle there and a shuffle there and fell over. And
when your centre of gravity is that low to the ground, you can get away with those sorts of things. So, terrific effort from Jimmy Jenkins.
Yeah. Fell over about three times as well.
He did too.
And he's got three for the afternoon, too.
Looked like smackers at about 10:30 on Saturday night.
It might be tonight, Kev.
So we're back in the middle again. Boyd got the tap. And now Western Region can work it through. Boyd again. And now through midfield. That's a spearing pass. Wasn't so accurate, though. Under there again is Jenkins. Little toe poke. It was very good. The kick bouncing towards goal. And Western Region are back into the lead. Wonderful stuff. And the goal was Prismal. Threw it onto the boot. And the Ballarat defender couldn't track it quickly enough. Lots and they're back up in front. And just when you thought Ballarat might skip away with it, they bounce back again. Two in a minute, and it's 11-15-81 to 11-10-76.
It all starts in the middle, doesn't it? The two centre clearances, and we've got two goals out of it. Big Boyd leading the way, the captain.
And Prismal's been good in the second half too, down there. A couple of goals in the second half.
Good move by Imsy to put him to centre forward.
Boyd again wins the hit out.
Free kick.
About time. Go on the Western Region way.
We're listening to you, mate.
He's going to Finco right in the centre of Whitnoble. Goes out wide, squares it, finds McDonald's. The lights start to take effect here at Whitnoble.
Not really.
kicks inside 50. Mark dropped by.
Throw it.
Miles there. Fills to Kennedy now for the Ballarat League. Now it comes out to Pitson. Kicks it down the line.
You've got to go, Josh.
Handball now out wide to Pring. It's been handy this afternoon. Looks inside 50. The Ferrari works his way to the front, but the ball spills out the back. To Banner, snaps around the corner, and right across the face of goal, and then goes out of bounds in the left forward pocket for the Ballarat Football League. 7 minutes gone, final quarter.
You can sense it now. They got their tails up a little bit off the back of those quick goals.
Yeah, and the crowd's starting to get involved now, Kev, here.
So Boyd and Boyd in the ruck again, taps it to the front, gets Dean, back to Boyd. Now just bombs it out of defensive 50. Looking for Graham, but the ball will beat him out of bounds. We have a throw in about 65 metres out from the Ballarat goal.
Yeah, the fitness is going to really kick in this quarter. That's going to be the big telling factor.
Yeah, throwing back in now. Armstrong Weston taps out the back to Panay. He gets a little chip ball with his left boot. Beautiful kick. There flies Castellano. Gives it back to Panay, who kept running. Now the long ball inside 50. Looking for Jenkins. He gathers, he's got two to beat, and he's not able to
lock
do
it. Lock it in, lock it in.
The help came. This hacked forward there by the rest of the region inside 50. And Hines wrapped up there by Perkins and Panay. Spills out the back now. The clearing kick comes to Pring for Ballarat. He's almost wrapped up in the tackle. Handball out even wider. Dean's there.
Dropped it.
Good boy.
Eddie Dean has won the free kick for the Ballarat, for the Western Region Footy
League.
There's
a bloke down behind play, Kev, for Ballarat. Just can't pick him up at the moment.
On the Doug Hawkins wing, Dean. Kicks towards half forward.
3-on-2.
Flat on the ground there is Graham. They got the numbers, though, Western Region. If they can get it out, Graham back onto his feet, slings one onto the right boot. It's inside 50.
Go, Abbott.
Tracking it quickly was Castellano. Hand pass back. He's going to get it again. He was dragged down as he kicked it.
Is that Hind?
I think it is Hind.
I don't like anyone getting injured, but...
I think it is Hind.
Yeah.
That's Hind where he, that's where he was when the ball was over there before.
Yeah, he doesn't look good. He looks in a lot of pain. Oh, wow.
Trying to put some weight on it now.
Oh, look at the kick.
The kick forward now for Western Region is chopped off by Sortino, the big ruckman. Now the kick from 40. Half back to half forward. Boyd at the back. Retrieve the spillage.
Just hold it up here. Wait for the right option here.
Yeah, that is Hind.
That's better.
That is Hind. That's a pity. He's been terrific.
Yep.
Still might be in the running for best on ground honours based on his work.
Didn't see the bloke. Poor handball.
Poor hand pass over the top. Bench did well enough though. Later tackle and now diving in again. Gets possession. Well, dunks
great
in
effort,
and under.
Josh.
Does well and it's found Spatiri. Had enough space to put him into the ground. Miles sold him into a bit of trouble. In there was Sablich as well. Ballarat though, they might be able to clear it out. Bench though, at the back of the pack, with the hand pass over the top to Quick, and he pumped it long inside the 50. Ballarat though, with all the numbers though, they all kind of flew at it. No one took the mark. Out of defence
good
now.
Hand.
Graham, quick hands for Ballarat, and now it's found the way through to Jackson Bolton. In a bit of space, takes a bounce on the Doug Hawkins wing, kicks inside the 50, leading up Cupid Oak, takes the mark on the lead on his chest, and he doesn't drop those, Damien Cupid Oak, and he can put Ballarat back into the lead if he can kick truly. 10 minutes gone of the final quarter. It's Western Region by 5 points.
We just needed a bit of composure around this last player along the corridor here. Just a couple of stray handballs, and we turned it over and found the hands of their full forward.
Composure is going to be a really important word. I mentioned fitness, but that's the other one. Fitness
and
composure.
There's a couple of boys down there cramping too, Kev.
One already today, Cupido. Can he put Ballarat back in front? No. Just drifted right again, and that's been the story up that end of the ground. Everything missing to the right-hand side.
We've got to get this right here, the kick-outs.
11-11
all day.
To 11-15, and they move it on quickly, which has tended to work out well for whoever's done that. The hand pass received again and poked over the top. It was well done. Tim Quick took the mark, but then he moved it on maybe a little too quickly. Miles had some space, fumbled, but there was no one near him, so he was able to recover. The kick was poor, Sortini, but he fisted it straight back to Miles. Well done there by McDonald. Darted
that's
around an
better
opponent, now spotted up his teammate in Dean. Has to stand on the spot and go back. Pokes one over the top. It was a good kick.
That's
found
better.
Bench, but he's 55 out. Too far out to score. Left forward flank. It's getting very dark out there.
The lights are on.
They're not really doing anything. That's a beautiful pass, though, over the top. And taking the mark, I believe it
Castellano
might have been Castellano. He's kicked 3 goals, and could he be the final term hero?
Just the wise head of Matty Dean there. He went back what we've been asking all day, took his time, spotted up the right lead, and it's eventually ended up in Abbott Costello's hands.
And we're right behind him. Castellano for goal number 4 to make it really tough for Ballarat.
He's got it.
It holds its line, and it's right through the middle. 12-15-87 to 11-11-77. It's 10 points the margin in favour of the home side. And after 12 minutes, that could be a decisive blow.
He's the chairman of selectors and the footy manager down there, Kev. They finally got their hands out of their pocket, and they brought him a cheer and a pat on the back there for Reece Miles.
Chris Graham comes onto the ground.
10 points the margin now. Ball's tossed back up. Got a free kick.
It's got to go our way.
For that infringement.
No.
He's going to carry for the Ballarat. Just pumps it long now inside 50. Looking for a marking target.
Two free kicks.
Free kick against Ferrari for a push.
Do you see Cubito then? Cubito was going, hey, hang on, what's this all about? Yeah. Oh, it's ours.
So the free kick is going to be paid to Vales against Ferrari.
I'm still not entirely sure how to pronounce that one.
Valet, maybe.
I've been calling him Valet, then Vales, I don't know.
Just hope he misses, boys.
Yeah, that's all that matters here.
Correct.
Goodness.
We're not biased.
Absolutely, so we are.
30 out, directly in front.
He shanked it badly,
pulled it to the left. Takes the margin back to 9 points, 12-15-87, 11-12-78, 13 and a half minutes gone on final quarter.
Need another goal here, Kev. We can't defend. We've still got to attack at the right time. And this is one area that will send shivers down our spine until we can get it across this half-back line here.
14 minutes gone of the final term. It's a 9-point lead to Western Region as Magna Bosco brings out a strong mark from Murray Boyd. He had the run at it and he took it with both hands. Left half-back flank. Decides to go long. No one really there. It's not a bad kick in the end. Well done by McDonald, throwing himself at the footy.
Free kick umpire.
No free kick paid.
Second Timmy Watson of the afternoon.
Mills had to jump in mid-air and only was taken out in full flight, knocked over the line, so will be thrown in. Centre wing, broadcast side of the ground.
This is where we're going to have to be on our toes here. Their outside run and spread from a stoppage has been killing us.
Both sides have got to be brave now. The game is there to be won. Armstrong Weston tried to wrench it out of the pack. He couldn't, and it trickles over the line.
I suppose it helps, Kev, with Hind off the ground.
Yeah.
He was the one that they feed off to. He's like the quarterback and away they go.
Certainly gave them their run and carry.
They go again. Carey was in the ruck there. It came down to Matthew Notman for Ballarat. Graham in there for Western Region. Ballarat plays a peel for a free kick for diving on it.
Murray
bottom
Boyd,
of the pack.
Murray Boyd playing that loose man
Matt
still.
Matt Dean, who's been good today, Matt Dean, I thought. Up they go. Big fist forward. Gains about 30 metres towards the boundary line. Trying to keep it in there was Dal Papa. He couldn't. So we'll have another boundary throw in. Just four to the wing. Ballarat's attacking side of the ground. They trail by 9 points. Midway through the final term. Up they go again. Sortino was in the ruck again. Jumping up there was Banner for Ballarat.
Got him.
At the back. Surely he's gone.
Dropping the ball, umpire.
He got a little bit of a toe poke to it, said the umpire. So the umpire's called play on. Out at the back, Chris Graham just hacks one forward. No, to no one's really at anyone's advantage. Or the bounce favoured Western Region, though. And here's Jenkins. Darts around, gets it off to Bench. Loves to go
Josh.
For a run. Takes a bounce. Cruises through the 50, almost got
no help.
Held for holding the ball, and he popped one up to the hot spot. But the only person there was Nathan Horbury, and he took the mark for Ballarat, and they can reload from full back.
Our forwards just ran away from him there. He had no option. They led to the wrong pocket.
So they're out here now, the Ballarat team, through Bucknell. Centres the ball. Comes in, was looking for Banner. Well spot there by Chris Graham. He's won
minutes.
The contest too. Gets the handball away to Savage. He goes on his left boot.
We're out.
He found Josh McDonald out there. Goes on his left boots inside 50
yes.
to Jenkins. He marks out on the lead and he'll kick for about 45 metres out. Plays on quickly. This Jenkins goes for goal.
That's
and
home.
Has
the left woodwork.
Point post.
Wow.
Hit the point post a few times today, the boys, or hit the post.
10 points the margin.
Horbury. Goes for a run, takes a bounce at left half-back as Ballarat again clear it out very quickly from their defence. That's a good kick. Banner finds space on centre wing, cruises into the centre square and kicks to full forward. Cupido one out at the back, but floating back and taking a strong mark was Matthew Ryan.
Just got to steady the play down here and wait for the right option. There it
again,
is.
Pokes one.
No.
That's not the best kick. Pring almost chopped it off, but Chris Graham, who's been good the last few minutes, did well. Got the hand pass back to Ryan. On his non-preferred left, pokes one over the top. That was well done. And Finko runs into the space in the back pocket and takes the mark. And that's a good kick. Spots up quick.
That's what they've got to do. Just control the footy for a minute. Wait for the right option. Don't panic.
Well, they're in a good position. They lead by 10. And the next goal is crucial in this game.
There's that loose man coming into effect, Kev. Murray Boyd.
Murray Boyd takes the mark and looks for Bench through midfield. He did
Josh.
Well. Takes the mark. He's got a player free at half forward. It's McDonald. He goes further afield than that, though. It might have been Castellano underneath it. They all dive in on top of him. And the umpire, I think, is going to ball it up.
Credit
40
to Murray. Credit to Murray Boyd. He's turned that spare in the back line into an attacking option in the last quarter.
And that's what Ballarat did in the first quarter with the
exactly.
two. They created the run off the half back with the loose man, the link up.
Sortino got the tap down. Tracking it towards the boundary was Jared Graham.
You get the people in Gordon Street to turn their front lights on.
I'll
tell you what, we needed it.
They're bringing out a yellow
out
footy.
There.
But it looks like they are putting new lights up, Kev.
Yeah, they are. Good. Yep. Talking to Ash Hansen, the coach of the Footscray VFL side earlier, and the new lights will be going in time for next season for some night games to be played here.
Sortino in front gets the hit out. Nice, does his own roving. Kennedy's there. Good handball there. Gets it to Tongue.
There's a
ball smothered Miles. Gave it up.
Got smothered. None of
Tongue
us
runs out of defence with it. Goes to Banner. Back to Kennedy. Now Miles. Banner gets involved again. Now pumps it long. Inside 50. Looking for Cupido. He's done well today. Quick on him. But Cupido breaks the tackle. Now centering ball, and a beautiful play by Damian Cupido finds Mikalev. He's taken a mark. They'll have a shot from 45 out directly in front, kicking to the Geelong road.
Still got a spare here.
He's going to go back and have a shot. He'd want to kick it.
20 minutes gone, final quarter.
Been hard to kick him from this end.
Mikalev coming in. It's almost pitch black here. Kicks on its way. Up, goal up by Moose to the left. And he's put it through, though. Big goal there for the Ballarat Football League. Reduced the margin to 4 points. And the WRFL now 12-16-88 to the Ballarat Football League 12-12-84. 20 minutes gone, final quarter.
Well, it's just going to come down to composure, the skill, and who has got the footy smarts and who won't panic when the pressure and the heat's on. Decision making, Kev.
Yep. It's that 100% wraps it up, and there's probably about maybe 10 minutes left, 9 minutes or thereabouts.
Back in the middle, Armstrong Weston got it down. Bench got a hand pass back. Now the kick inside 50. Ballarat with the numbers. It was tapped well.
There's a go, go hard.
Well done. They break through, the kick towards goal. It goes to the line. Did anyone touch it? They did, said the umpire.
How can he see?
So that margin now 5 points, 12-17 to 12-12 after 20 and a half minutes. So we're into time on in the final term.
Just need this pressure in this inside.
This bloke's just come off the bench.
Mitch Banner takes the mark and then spots up Pitson, who comes off the interchange, gives it back to Kennedy, who backtracks, had nothing really to run towards, has to go backwards again. So now under pressure. Good kick to the advantage, though,
numbers
of Valais. He couldn't take the mark. And now at the back, Graham. Well done.
In the middle.
Gave it off to Sablich. That's a dangerous kick, though. Chris Graham did well, but it was a mark still paid to Bucknell. And they've got players everywhere inside 50. Ballarat, if they can take the mark. And it has been taken. Jackson Bolton, he thought about giving it off, but instead he'll take responsibility himself from about 40 metres out in the right forward pocket.
We just spoke about it, Kevin. It was just the wrong option at the wrong time. He battles his guts out, Davey, but he does make some mistakes.
To put Ballarat in front.
And the crowd's behind it.
Never.
The under 19 boys.
12-13-85, Ballarat. They trail Western Region 12-17-89. And if either side loses this in a close one, I'm sure they can both rue a few missed chances out there today.
Been a terrific contest between the two sides. Yeah. No doubt about that.
Certainly.
Magna Bosco took the kick in. Look for Boyd's won the free kick.
Jeez, he's been good after
right half.
Terrific.
So Murray Boyd, the captain, kicked the opening goal of the afternoon. Looking for options. He's going to have to go down the line. Does. A short one. But he's miscued badly. Put it out on the full. He's looking for Perkins. So free kick goes to Ballarat as they drive the ball back inside 50. Looking for a marking option. Almost there for Ballarat. Pring gets it. Snaps around the body. But there's no one home. And the mark taken on the last line of defence by Magna Bosco. Goes
hello,
long.
Ken.
Good kick.
Looking for Sablich. Just outside defensive 50 marks. Plays on. Now kicks down the line looking for...
That's a free!
Langlands. He's been paid the free kick.
Take it back, Tommy. Come
on, Tommy.
Yeah, he hasn't got the leg speed.
Good umpiring, Smackers.
How long have we got, boys?
We've got about 10 minutes.
Oh, jeez.
A long time. Yeah, we had long quarters here. Langlands squares it up to Brian Graham.
Oh, around over the other side of it.
Chips it to his brother, Chris, inside the centre square. He's held up by Sortino working the mark. Chris Graham goes out wide, looking for bench. Can't take the mark. Got a foot race here. Miles for the Western Region. Works in front, does well. Handball's back inside, but gives it up to Bucknell. The ball's still in dispute here. Chris Graham follows up. Done by Jared Graham there for Ballarat. Now gets the kick inside 50. Looking for Anderson. Can't take the mark. Picked up by Pring. Turns around on the right boot, has a shot, and misses to the left.
He's dangerous at Pring, isn't he?
24 minutes gone. The margin is 3 points. Western Region Footy League 12-17-89. Ballarat 12-14-86.
So they bridge the gap by another behind as Western Region bring it out. Spatiri takes the mark. Still just inside the 50 left. Back pocket. 24 minutes play to the final term. They lead by 3 points, the home side. Kick looking for Boyd. Couldn't quite take the mark. At the front of the pack was Chris Graham. Jumping in there. There's a slew of players. So we'll have a bounce. Right half forward for Ballarat. Up they go. It was tapped and then it was tapped again by Sortino. And now right half forward. Jumping in there was Sablich. He was brought down. Maybe high. Umpire said no. And now they'll ball it up. So Ballarat trying to lock it in as they pursue
and all
just
over the
one goal
now.
They need.
All over the ground. It's man on man.
That's what we love to see. Graham gathers it. Hand pass missed the target, though, and it's out of bounds.
There's not one loose here, so it's just going to come down to contested footy and being quick with your hands and getting it moving forward.
Who can stand up under the pressure? Because there is plenty of it out there. 3 points the lead. 25 gone to the final quarter. The time is elapsing quickly. Kennedy for Ballarat tries to get his hands on it. There's so much little time out there. Little kick forward. Pring was there. Front position. Gathered it.
Well.
Got through. Got the hand pass over the top.
Notman.
Can he kick the goal to put Ballarat in front? He can. A clutch moment from Matthew Notman. He weaved his way through traffic and it was thanks to Pring with his quick hands. And they lead by 3 points. 25 and a half minutes gone in the final term. 13-14, 92 to 12-17, 89.
We mentioned Pring earlier, Smackers. He's a bit of a class player.
Yeah. He's just a bit too quick. And
gets the footy.
Yeah, he just gets out the back and he's an opportunist. And he set that one up there, Kev.
26 minutes gone, final quarter. Ball's tossed back up in the middle. Boyd, Sortino go at it again. Ball's battled forward for Ballarat. Handball out wide goes to Banner. Now Banner pumps it long inside 50s. No one really home there. And the ball is going to...
There he is again.
Pring out of bounds. Yeah, it is. Close.
Keep it in.
It was almost away there, Pring, but the ball beat him. Ball beat him out of bounds. He'll have a throw in about 20 metres round from the Ballarat goals.
It's all or nothing now.
3 points the margin in favour of Ballarat. Toss back in. Boyd gets the hit out. It's crumbed by Brian Graham. Hacks it out. But it's as far as Sortino, who took the good mark. Sort of making the wall there, Ballarat gets a handball back. Now the ball's going to be pumped back in. It is looking for Cupido.
There's a turnover.
And it's a turnover here, picked up by McDonald. Handball's out wide to Magna Bosco. Gets back on his right foot, goes back inboard.
Here we go, this is it.
Dean marks, handball's to Sablich. He's got Finko running by.
And he's wrong foot.
And there's another handball inboard to Langlands. He kicks long inside 50. Looking for a mark.
It's holding. It's a free kick.
Paid. Free kick to Panai.
Look at the boys, they're up and about.
Lane Buckwell grabbed the fair chunk of the jumper there. So Panai's going to have a shot at goal from about 30 metres out directly in front.
That was a silly free kick.
It was.
A really silly free kick.
Kevy had a shot from here just on half time, probably 10 metres closer, and he kicked it out in the full.
Yeah, he had a shot, I remember, in a home and away game. Willow, you'd remember this one against him.
Yeah, against Deer Park from 50.
Against Deer Park,
yeah.
At Deer Park, and he missed it. Let's hope he doesn't repeat that.
So Panai comes in, kicks on its way, goal umpire,
goal.
Does not move, he's put it straight through the middle. Goal to Andrew Panai. The Western Region retake the lead, 13-17, 95 to 13-14, 92. A three-point lead, 28 minutes gone, final quarter.
Oh, what a ball game we've got here, boys. Right down to the wire, two great... competition's going head and head here, isn't it?
And it's how just, good is Interleague?
Yeah, sensational here, and the experience now in there. Matty Dean, Tommy Langlands, young Joshy Benson, Murray Boyd.
You can't help but get caught up in the moment. And Western Region will go forward from the centre break to centre half forward. There's a foot race now. McKenzie's there.
Yep.
McDonald, sorry, not McKenzie.
Well done, Josh.
Holding the footy, no. But they've still got time to go inside
numbers.
50. That's a good kick. And they got
hold
players. There's a player free at full forward if they can get it to him. But they close off the space.
Been told to hold it up hold by the bench, up. I can tell you.
Topsy would have been yelling.
Oh,
McDonald goes to the top of the... coming in from the side. Couldn't quite bring down the mark. And
gotta
now Ballarat might be
here.
Able to squid, kick it forward. And filling that hole in the middle of the ground.
Hold it up. Hold it up.
Great mark by Ferrari.
Joshy McDonald's on over here.
He takes the mark. That's a poor kick. McDonald's got to keep this in. He does. That's got to be a good kick. It's a beauty. Bench diving forward. And he was pushed
50.
Over. Is that 50? No.
Come on up.
Gee, it might have been a little harsh. Bench now.
Oh.
Short kick.
There it is, the siren's gone.
And for the first time, we go a sub 30 minute quarter. We weren't expecting it, but the Western Region Football League have hung on and won by 3 points in a thrilling encounter as the light fades at Witten Oval. Andrew Panai was the hero with the goal with only a minute or two to go. And the final score, 13-17-95 to Ballarat, 13-14-92. The home side, they withstood numerous challenges throughout the day. And while Ballarat... Hey.
How good's that?
Don't you love footy? Don't you love it?
What a good game of footy.
You know, what a great exhibition of football from both sides, you know, the Western Region and the Ballarat League. You know, this is what it's all about. Metropolitan football, country football, interleague football. It's here forever. This is what it's all about. Great game. Great win. Character to our boys, I tell you. You know, going and kicking against probably a 2-3 goal win at the end, that last quarter, just to hold the ball at the right time and, you know, never say die. That's what we spoke about during the week, my friend. Loving. Loving.
Good stuff, Stevie.
Hey, Kevin, you are down on the ground. I thought you snuck into the timekeeper's box, mate. It was a bit short that quarter.
It was the shortest one we've had.
By about 5 minutes.
I thought we still had about 4 minutes to go,
so
to be honest.
Long
quarters, the first three.
I didn't even hear the siren. You guys were yelling too much.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
We didn't expect it to go off. What was that?
Well,
we 29
minutes gone. Yeah, every first
every
quarter, 33. Second quarter, 36. Third quarter, 33.
Yeah, no, sensational. It was never die attitude from both sides. They give it their all. There'll be some sore bodies out there, but you just heard in the voice of Stevie Toms. He's been involved with the interleague for the last 3 or 4 years, and we're a bit stiff last year. We come up against the Eastern League.
It was a good performance last year.
We fell away after three-quarter time. They overrun us. This year, I know that wasn't the best side we could put out there. We got struck down by injuries.
The grandstand boys. Ladies and gentlemen who are still here, have enjoyed this spectacle, I know you've stayed till the end. Please put your hands together for these two sides. What a great game of footy. Head over towards where I am, boys. The Ballarat boys could come down too, please. First up, I'd like to call on Sean O'Loughlin, the coach of Ballarat. Who is Sean? Just on their way down from the coach's box, so... shouldn't be too far away. So I'll present the medals to the two players judged by their coaching staffs as the best on ground. And then the cup to the winning team today. But fantastic effort from both teams. Terrific stuff. Well done. The WorkSafe AFL Victoria Community Championship. Today the trophy, of course, goes to the Western Region Footy League. Well, rather than hold it up, we'll come back to Sean for that. But can I ask Anthony Eames to come over, the coach of the Western Region Footy League side. Eamesy, do tell us who your coaching panel has judged as the medal winner for best on ground for the Western Region Footy League. All the coaches have disappeared on us, have they? Oh, they're just working it out now. Ace down here, mate. Right, just a few words first on the game, and then tell us who you've judged best on ground.
Oh, geez, it was sharp, the game. I thought their speed, you know, particularly on the outside, started to hurt us a bit. So, we turned it over and made some mistakes. They were breaking tackles, all that sort of stuff. So I think the spirit we did, you know, against that Breeze in the last quarter was terrific.
And who have you judged to be the best on ground from the coaching panel?
Oh, look, I thought it was fairly solid across the board, but I just love the contribution of Matty Dean, so we'll take that one.
Matty Dean, Barry Priest medalist from a cup. Come down, Matty. Mick Danaher from AFL Victoria to present you with your medal for best on ground. Can I ask Sean O'Loughlin to come over and tell us who the... Sean? Well done, Matty. Good work. G, just a few words on what was a terrific game of football, great effort from both sides, and then tell us who you've given the medal to.
Yeah, first of all, to Anthony and the Western Region boys, well done. Played really well and deserved a win at the end. We thought we might have just got you at the end, but you got another one on us. So well done, congratulations, and all the best with your footy for the remainder of the season. Just to our guys, well done. It was a really good effort. You kept trying to play the way that we thought that would be the way that would win us the game, and in the end it just wasn't quite good enough. But you know, your commitment to the BFL is fantastic, and I know that the BFL board and all the people involved with the BFL are really proud of what you've done. I'd also just like to thank all the coaches and support staff that have done such a wonderful job in supporting the players.
And the medal for your best on ground?
It's a bit of a sore point for us, but unfortunately the fella Nick Hind, who was our best player, is off to hospital. I think he might have a broken leg, but he played a fantastic game, number two.
Yeah, he was fantastic, terrific. Put your hands together for Heidi, who gets that the medal now. I'd like to call on Mick Danaher to present the trophy to the winning coach and the captain, Murray Boyd. Boydie. Congratulations on winning the Community Championship WorkSafe Trophy. Well done. A couple of happy snaps there. Geez, I think they've taken our cataracts out with those. Boydie, just come over, mate. It was a tough, hard-fought game, and in the end, just came down to the barest of margins, just about.
Yeah, it certainly was. Yeah, full-on challenge the whole game. The boys dug deep in that last quarter with the breeze going into the breeze. But, yeah, it was just good hit out. Thanks for the Ballarat boys. Yeah, good win.
Yeah, that pretty much sums it up, Boydie. Well done, mate. Congratulations. Celebrate with the boys. Murray Boyd there, the skipper of the Western Region Footy League. Once again, to both sides, thank you very much for what's been a fantastic contest. And the under-19s beforehand, which was also terrifically played out by the two sides. So the WorkSafe AFL Victoria Community Championship. Congratulations to the Western Region Footy League. Thank you very much to the Ballarat Football League. Good on you, Kenners, and all the boys. Well done.
Yes, well, a fantastic game here at Witten Oval, and right now, as we keep on continuing on with the broadcast, we'll go to the phones and see who we have on the line here. You're on the air with 88.9. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, hello. No, we've lost our phone caller too, so we'll get Crimo on that, make sure our wiring's still up to speed, but they'll be calling back. Well, a fantastic win there by the WRFL, holding off a very gallant Ballarat side by 3 points, 13-7-95 to 13-14-92. Smackers, I think Tom's going to be very proud down there.
Kev's just going to go over to Tim
grabbing Jenkins. Timmy Jenkins. I just want to bust a few of those moves that he did down here in the forward pocket and show us exactly what he's done. That was...